Tantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Beyond Tidy. Declutter your mind and discover the magic of organized living. By Annmarie Brogan and Marie Limpert of Organize Me of New York, LLC. Narrated by Erin deWard. Introduction. Congratulations. If you are reading this, then you have hope. You believe even to the smallest degree that you can learn to be more organized and change the way things currently are. More importantly, you believe that you can play a direct role in making that change. There can be no change without hope. So even if this book is your Hail Mary play, you're still in the game and we celebrate you. When we were first approached about writing a book, it was important to stay true to ourselves as teachers of organizing strategies. We've been professional organizers for 13 years, and in that time, we've worked hard to craft proven systems and language that motivates and resonates with those who come to us for help. There are many organizing books out there, so what do we offer that's different than the others? What can we bring to the party that causes a tangible shift for you, the reader? What makes us unique is our emphasis on the why behind all the what's we are asking you to do. We want you to understand the impact behind each tip, strategy, and suggestion. By impact, we mean how your life and circumstances will be positively affected, including improvements in your state of mind and emotional well-being. It's not just about the way things appear on the outside. There is an abundance of research that supports the benefits of cultivating positivity, increasing optimism and hope, and staying motivated. This book is a fusion of our best organizing principles with positive and behavioral psychology. While the primary focus is on organizing, we sprinkle the research throughout the book in an easily digestible way to support the principles we teach. We believe that when you combine conceptual understanding with tangible, proven strategies, you will be equipped to handle any organizing challenge. In other words, we go beyond tidy to a much higher level. To begin, we reflected a lot on the many different reasons people have called us over the years. The range of demographics, circumstances, and physical/mental health challenges that make up and affect our client base would probably surprise you. Yet the negative emotions attached to feeling disorganized are consistent across all of the factors. One thing is clear. There are many reasons why people are disorganized. Some have simply never been organized. Maybe they were raised in a cluttered and chaotic environment where things were always out of place. Perhaps they never learned good strategies at home or at school. Some truly believe they weren't blessed with the organizing gene and therefore aren't innately organized. They call us when their disorganization is adversely affecting their lives, work, and/or relationships, and something needs to change. Others struggle with mental health challenges, such as depression, anxiety, or ADHD, which make it truly difficult to stay focused and on task. They come to us to simplify their lives and learn techniques for making things more manageable. Then there are those who have always been super organized until a life event gets them off track. Think death of a loved one, birth of a child, need to go back to work, unexpected job loss, etc. Not used to feeling out of control and scattered, mastering their new normal becomes top of the priority list. Combine this with different personalities, circumstances, and family dynamics, and it's obvious that a one-size-fits-all approach isn't effective. However, The more we reflected, the clearer it became that our clients' successes over the years have been rooted in key unifying factors. We come to you without judgment. As we just mentioned, there are a lot of reasons why people get to a point where they feel they need our help. Our clients learn quickly that our goal is to empower and help them move forward. This calls for more than just teaching tips and tricks, although we've got plenty of them. It requires feeling free from perceived judgment, including self-judgment, which often renders people immobile and unable to take that first step. We invite you to come to this process with self-compassion. Give yourself permission to be human as you navigate new ways to approach organization, leaving any self-judgment at the door. We work as a team. We are teachers, motivators, collaborators, and strategists. While we feel becoming more organized will lead to greater self-esteem, our energy is spent helping to increase your self-efficacy, the belief in your abilities to handle challenges and complete tasks successfully. We believe in your resourcefulness, even though you may be feeling quite incapable and out of control. When people truly feel safe and supported, they are free to take risks and try new things. They become excited to explore and learn. As your teammates, we help you increase positive emotions in order to build curiosity and openness to what's possible. As Dr. Barbara Fredrickson explains in her book Positivity, positivity broadens our minds and expands our range of vision. A broad mind changes the way you think and act in a wide range of circumstances. When you see more ideas come to mind, more actions become possible. Positive emotions broaden and build and cause upward spirals that filter into other areas of life. Think of it as a positive chain reaction. We build trust. We understand how emotional and overwhelming life can be when a person is disorganized, especially when he or she begins to unpack the underlying causes of his or her disorganization. Our clients trust us with so much more than just their physical belongings. They also share their feelings, emotions, insecurities, and secrets, the things that make them most vulnerable. We get to see sides of them they don't share with their closest family and friends. We do not take that trust for granted, and we come to each project with compassion and respect. Conversely, part of the way in which we empower our clients is through our trust in their capabilities. We believe wholeheartedly that anyone who comes to us with a sincere desire to improve their situation can learn what we have to teach. If they are willing to shift their mindset and establish new behavior patterns, they can and will achieve organizing success. So, perhaps the most powerful gift we offer is this. Throughout the process, we cultivate a growth mindset, a belief that talent and ability are not fixed, but merely starting points for what's possible with hard work, dedicated practice, and a sincere desire to learn. It is human nature to compare ourselves to others, and the disorganized person often feels like everyone else has it all together. But don't let a fixed mindset stop you. This is not an either you have the organizing gene or you don't situation. Dr. Carol Dweck of Stanford University says, just because some people can do something with little or no training, it doesn't mean that others can't do it, and sometimes do it even better with training. We help our clients reframe negative, limiting thoughts and beliefs into positive, curious, and more solution-focused ones. So, how does all this translate from working with us in person to what you will find in this book. We begin by answering this question with two more, which definitely would have annoyed our parents growing up. What if we were to tell you that being organized isn't what you might think it is? What if we begged you, just for a little while, to stop looking at those jaw-dropping pictures of seemingly organized perfection on Pinterest? No, really, stop looking at Pinterest. Pinterest is only a surface look at what your space and life could be. It does not reflect what the inner state of being organized actually means. Simply put, organizing is knowing what you have and where to find it when you need it. It means not wasting time and money replacing things you already own because you can't find them. It means being reliable and on time for appointments, since getting ready to go out no longer feels like competing in an Olympic event. It means taking the space you have and getting the most out of it. It means managing your energy for more important decisions and tasks, which gives you better emotional regulation and willpower. The bottom line, it means creating a life that you love, one that has been deliberately designed by you, rather than a life that is simply a byproduct of the chaos around you. Organized people are resilient. They have strategies and a plan B for when unexpected things come up. They aren't fully derailed, and they remain confident and optimistic that they can get back on track quickly. In fact, research shows that those people who plan for how they will implement their goals triple their chances of success. This is true even for difficult goals. Organizing is not how neat and tidy something looks on the outside. We've seen many a pristine-looking home that has chaos lurking behind every cabinet door. Rather, it's how the setup and layout of your drawers, cabinets, and closets support the way you and your family want to live. For example, both of us have very organized kitchens with a specific flow. But each kitchen is tailored to the unique needs of our families. One of us has an aging parent who tries to sneak foods he isn't supposed to eat, so certain foods need to be kept up high and out of reach because she can't trust him. The other one of us keeps those same foods in plain sight because it's not an issue with her family. We often say, there is no right or wrong way to organize as long as there's an organized way. We tailor organizing solutions to the unique personalities, needs, and circumstances of our clients. However, there are basic principles that we teach all of our clients, and these principles are what we focus on here. And the best part is that even though mastering these principles can have a profound impact on your life, they are actually very simple to learn and implement. If disorganization is affecting your quality of life and preventing you from showing up in the world the way you want to, confidently, reliably, and with an abundance of positive energy, then this book is for you. What you can expect. Each chapter will cover one of our top 8 organizing principles. What it is in easy-to-understand language, why it's important, how it will impact you, what it will save you, time, money, energy, space. We will also include personal stories, favorite social media posts, and many case studies from our real-life clients. These chapters are designed to help you understand not only what to do, but also why we recommend it and how it will impact you. This is so important in keeping you motivated and empowered. Although mastering any one of these principles can have a positive effect, we will show you how once you master them all, You can interweave them into seamless and effortless organizing systems that help you create a home and life you love. We are honored to be on this journey with you. Happy organizing. Annmarie and Marie. Part 1. Creating Your Mindset. Chapter 1. Change on the outside must begin with change on the inside. Deep, huh? You may be thinking, I signed up for tangible organizing tips, not New Age philosophy. Yet, there's no way around it. We must start with this idea, because if you aren't willing to reset your thinking and change your behavior, none of the rest will matter. Wanting to be organized is not enough. There is controversy over whether or not Einstein really offered his own definition of insanity, but it's true nevertheless. Insanity is doing the same thing over and over again, but expecting different results. If you keep cleaning, straightening, organizing, and things always go back to the way they were, it's because something you're doing isn't working. There's something you're not doing, or there's something you're not doing consistently. No matter what, the key is to change your mindset. Mindset affects your behavior, which then in turn reinforces your mindset. They are connected. Therefore, you can't fully learn the organizing principles that will drive new behaviors and habits without first exploring your innate belief system. Let us show you how changing your mindset first is the key to unlocking your inner organizational gene. Yes. See what we did there? Our thoughts are very powerful. They are the lens through which we see the world, and the underlying factor behind how we react to situations and events in our lives. They also determine what, if any, action we take in response. This is a main reason why two people can experience the same exact situation, yet react very differently. Years ago, we worked with a schoolteacher who was divorced and living with her young son. She called us because the clutter in her house had gotten out of control. The disorganization was causing her significant anxiety. In fact, she said it was sucking the life out of her. During the session, she confided that she had grown up in a family where things were never thrown out. Turns out, her parents had lived through the Great Depression, where food was scarce and the option to buy new things wasn't always viable. Old clothing was given to other family members or made into other items, such as rags or pillows. Broken gadgets and appliances were kept for parts, in case such parts could ever be repurposed. They made do with what they had and came up with creative ways to repurpose everything so it never went to waste. Even after the Depression ended, this mindset prevailed and shaped the way her parents lived long after they could well afford what they needed. Donating was hard, despite the idea that their unused things could go to the less fortunate. Perhaps because they had been the less fortunate, they couldn't bear to part with anything they acquired, for any reason. Even letting go of broken items was painfully difficult. The stuff they held onto took valuable space away from other, more used items, and as a result, they lived in a cluttered and uninviting home. Our client, on the other hand, held a different mindset. She believed that clutter was a barrier to living a better, easier-to-manage life. She couldn't fathom why anyone would want to keep several broken vacuum cleaners or stained clothing that didn't even fit. Far from causing anxiety, setting aside things for donation made her feel lighter and more in control of her space. Putting broken items in the garbage was a no-brainer. What was causing her anxiety was the fact that, for a variety of reasons, her house had started to resemble her childhood home. She did not want her son to grow up in that environment or develop her parents' mindset about his belongings. This is what prompted her to call us. Two different belief systems, two very different ways of approaching and reacting to the organizing process. Henry Ford famously said, "Whether you think you can or think you can't, you're right." If you hold a strong belief that you can never learn to be organized or nothing you do will matter, it will be difficult to stay open to new suggestions or maintain a good level of motivation. In contrast, if you hold a strong belief that it is possible to learn and improve new skills with dedication and practice, you will be more likely to stay the course and keep moving forward even when you encounter obstacles. Research studies in the field of neuroplasticity have shown that the brain is very malleable and adaptive. Every time you learn something new, neurons or nerve cells in the brain fire up and create new neural pathways. You are literally rewiring your brain to adapt to new information and situations. You are changing both the structure and the functionality of your brain. The implications of this are incredibly exciting and go far beyond what we'll cover here. For our purposes, it means that it is biologically possible to change the way we think and therefore how we see the world. It also means that with dedication and effort, we can learn new skills, develop better habits, and create a different way of interacting with our environment and the people in it. That is something big to celebrate. Even if you've always believed that you could never get better at organization, or any skill for that matter, science is proving that theory wrong. According to Dr. Carol Dweck, a leading researcher on the topic of mindset, there are two main types: a fixed mindset and a growth mindset. Those with a fixed mindset believe that their abilities, intelligence, and talent are set in stone and can't be developed. They view the need to put forth effort as a sign of low talent or ability. Therefore, they avoid challenges that might expose them as deficient. In contrast, people with a growth mindset believe that their basic abilities are just the foundation and can be developed and cultivated through hard work, dedication, and practice. They view challenges and even failures as opportunities to learn and improve. We believe that a growth mindset is essential for success and for living a happier, more flourishing life. So our approach is always to work from a place of curiosity and possibility. We want you to think in terms of what you are building and creating, not what you are giving up or losing. The first way feels much more empowering and purposeful. The second feels stressful and demotivating. We encourage you to be an active creator of your dream life, and there's no room for negativity in the process. Therefore, the first step in the process is to start paying attention to your mind chatter. We don't know about you, but there are a lot of thoughts that race through our heads throughout the day. Can you relate? What are your thoughts telling you, and are they serving you in reaching your goals? On any given day, would you say your thoughts are more positive or more negative? A single negative thought is one thing. We all have negative thoughts that pop up here and there. However, repeated thoughts become our beliefs. And when those beliefs are negative, limiting, and/or self-sabotaging, they can create quite a bit of chaos. It is very important to note that negative thoughts aren't necessarily accurate thoughts, which is why they should be challenged. We want to become aware of the narrative in our head so we can talk back to negative thoughts and reframe them. So, how can we change negative thoughts? Sadly, we can't just toss them out the window. We can't unthink our thoughts. We can only replace them with better feeling and better serving ones. The more we repeat these better thoughts, the stronger they become and the more they become etched in our brain, literally and figuratively. As they do, the negative thoughts become weaker and weaker and have much less of an impact. Thank you, neuroplasticity. This is, of course, easier said than done. We are biologically wired to place greater emphasis on the negative. In positive psychology, this is referred to as our negativity bias, and we all have it. Centuries ago, it's what kept our ancestors safe from threats to their survival. We still have that same wiring, but it affects us differently in today's world. Here's an easy-to-understand example. If we receive feedback on a project or performance and someone says 5 positive things and 1 negative thing, what do most people hone in on? The 1 negative thing, and sometimes to the complete exclusion of the positive things also mentioned. We have a client who begins every session by telling us everything she hasn't done or kept up with since we last saw her. Without fail, throughout the session, we learn all the things she has accomplished and maintained, and it is often a long list. She is an absolute rock star, but her negativity bias game is strong. It's something she's working on, and we support her by ending each session with a recap of everything she has accomplished. That's why we always encourage our clients and followers to celebrate the wins. It's not just about the end result. It's about the different ways we learn and grow throughout the journey. That's what keeps us in a more positive frame of mind and more willing to try things we might not have considered before. The reality is, there are many different ways to approach an organizing project, and there are factors that are unique to each family. Sometimes it takes a few tries to get things right, so having a growth mindset is key to navigating the process and not giving up. We are also believers in affirmations and expressing our goals in the positive, preferably in language that suggests what you desire has already happened or is happening. I am organized and reaching my goals. I am on top of my finances and my paperwork. I have good systems in place so my house doesn't become cluttered. I am learning new ways to make my household run more smoothly. I am proud of how far I have come. Every day, I am improving. Every day, I am one step closer to reaching my goals. When I have a setback, I trust in my ability to handle it. I have an effective and reliable plan B. I am as prepared as I can be. What affirmations can you come up with on your own? Bottom line, believe you can. Commit to change. Proactively take down negative mind chatter. Move forward fearlessly. Allow us to offer a few more thoughts before we get to our top organizing principles. Although the systems we offer our clients are tailored to their specific needs and vision, there are basic things to keep in mind as you embark on this adventure. Reset your thinking. Remember, the clutter and disorganization likely did not happen overnight, so it is unreasonable to think that it could be erased overnight. Understand that this will be an ever-changing journey, and there will be steps forward and back along the way. The steps back can provide valuable insight and opportunities for self-discovery. This is why a growth mindset is so important. Reflecting back on the past has the potential to make you feel bad about how things may have gotten to this point. It's perfectly natural to have feelings of discomfort and unease. Having self-compassion will allow you to move through the reflection without being weighed down by negativity. Self-reflection can be good and healthy when it's done from a place of curiosity and with an intention to move forward. What wasn't working before? What got in the way? What did work and is still working? What would you like to change moving forward? How would making positive changes impact different areas of your life? Focus on what can be learned and how you can use this information to create a space and life that aligns with your values and desires. Long walk, baby steps. This is particularly important for those who are in an extreme state of disorganization. If you view this as one big project, you are going to get overwhelmed and subsequently discouraged. You will feel bad about yourself. This journey is not about self-loathing, self-judgment, or what-ifs. It's about being in the present and learning from past mistakes to shape a better and happier future. Very rarely does everything go 100% smoothly the first time. You will try some perfectly good systems that simply don't work for you and your family. These are just setbacks, not failures. Another difference between a growth and fixed mindset is how a person perceives failure. A person with a fixed mindset says, "I'm a failure," and uses that as an excuse for not trying anymore. The failure is viewed as validation that they are not good enough. A person with a growth mindset says, "I've failed this time around. What can I learn from this? What can I do differently next time?" The failure is viewed as an opportunity to grow. So don't give up if you try a few things and they don't work. With each attempt, you will learn a little more about yourself, your family, and how to approach the organizing process. Eventually, you will hit upon what works for you, and it will be worth your patience and effort. Keep the inner and outer conversation positive. As you become organized, you will feel excited and hopeful. You will feel other emotions, too. Many clients express remorse and sadness that they allowed things to get out of control. Don't focus on those negative emotions. They will only impede your progress. Focus on the fact that you have committed to turning things around and are making progress. You must be your first motivator, and then surround yourself with others who support you. Speaking of which, don't be surprised if all of your hard work doesn't spark the validation and gratitude from your family as you hope it will. Our clients have received a variety of responses to their organizing efforts. No reaction at all. Say what? That's right. Some clients have worked their butts off to get a room decluttered or their paperwork in order, only to have their spouse or children come home and not notice anything looks different. Even when told about the organizing, the spouse or children say, "It looks the same," or "Looks like nothing got done." They don't recognize it as the huge undertaking it was. This is very disheartening and a real downer after the high of organizing success. No one can understand the process unless they go through it. Some people think organizing means throwing everything out. So if they see a room full of stuff, they think nothing has changed. However, you know what's changed. You know the work you've put in. Now you know exactly what you have and where to find it. You can access it easily. Your space is being used more efficiently, and you have more control. Anxiety or paranoia? Did those ladies touch my stuff? Where is everything? How much did all of this cost? Shouldn't you be able to do this on your own? Insecurity or defensiveness. After all, you getting organized makes their disorganization more apparent. They might outwardly put down or downright sabotage the work you've been doing. We know. We've witnessed it. And it makes staying motivated and focused that much harder. That's why it's important you not start this process for anyone or anything other than your own desire to make positive changes. You can't control other people's reactions and behavior.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.